Please subscribe and don't forget to press the bell icon to get notified whenever we upload a new video.
CNBC TV18's Nisha Poddar caught up with Keki Mistry and started by asking on the utilization of funds recently raised by the company. Take a listen.
We use for a variety of purposes. Firstly, we need to keep putting capital into our various subsidiaries. HDFC Credila, we put in money. HDFC Credila is an education finance business. Then we said we would look at the health insurance business. Currently, there is nothing in sight. There is no company that we are looking at or talking to, but it's something which we have in mind. It would require capital, whether it's organic or inorganic, it would require capital. So that's the second area of growth. Third is we talked about distressed real estate business. So whilst it would be a fund structure, some percentage of the money in that fund will have to be put in by us to give confidence to ultimate investors. All of that will consume capital over a period of time.
So now what is the next stage of growth and value creation for the shareholders that you're looking at?
I talked briefly about HDFC Credila, saying we infused some capital into that business recently. We have HDFC ERGO, which is a foray into PNC insurance. At some point of time, over the next 3 to 5 years, we would certainly look at listing these companies. But we have to do it at the right time. It's not necessary that we have to do it to this year or next year. Mm-hmm. But when we believe the time is right in terms of gaining sufficient size, then that is a time we would look at listing these businesses. But these are businesses which at some point of time could be listed.
So is it going to be two general insurance and health insurance separate? Is that the strategy or all rolled into
one?
Well,
the ideal strategy would be that HDFC general subject, of course, to regulatory requirements being complied with, that HDFC general insurance sets up a wholly owned subsidiary or carries out the health insurance business as a subsidiary of HDFC general insurance. That's the ideal strategy that we would like to look at, subject, of course, to it meeting regulatory.
Life insurance business, now that's doing well. In fact, the stock has been performing very well as well. Now, what is the next stage in terms of strategy and growth for that company? And inorganic growth in that also is something to beef it up further?
We've done some inorganic growth in a general insurance business, where we bought over L&T General Insurance a couple of years ago. But in the life business, we've never had inorganic growth. And despite that, we've had a stable growth. So our profit margins are good. And we would like to consistently keep growing and keep eyes open for any inorganic growth opportunity which is.
Even in health insurance as well, you did look at Star Health. Now it's gone at 6,500 crore rupees. Having been in the insurance space now for a while, how do you measure the valuation expectations, these valuations?
Well, it's not for me to comment on why the Star Health valuation is 6,500 crores, but our valuation was lower and we put in a value at that price.